Hello, today I'm going to talk to you about different programming environments you can code Julia in. But first, I'm going to start at kind of a weird place. The question, why is programming difficult? To me, there are two reasons why programming is hard. First is writing the code itself, understanding the programming logic, like how for loops work, why exactly print line works the way it does, multiple dispatch, all of this kind of stuff. The other challenge, which I think is actually even more difficult, at least for beginning programmers, is running that code on your own machine. The reason I think this is because when I started to learn to code, you know, quite a few years ago, I found that I could genuinely understand most of the programming logic the textbook was trying to teach me. I understood loops, I understood conditionals, I understood basically everything that I needed to do. I could write the code. I just couldn't figure out how to get it to run. And I tried so many different things and I could not figure it out. The textbook was trying to get me to use some sort of IDE that I genuinely didn't understand. It wasn't until I opened up a terminal and I learned that I could compile code in that terminal that I actually learned how to write code properly. And to me, being able to run code in that terminal and being able to look at the file that I'm typing and write it in my own text editor was essential for me understanding code itself. So this brings me to my main point. Different programming environments make running code easier for different people, and different people gain intuition by writing code in different ways. So now I want to talk a bit about what programming environments are available. And to me, there are three general classes. The first is basic text editors. The next are integrated development environments, or IDEs, which I alluded to earlier. And the last are notebooks. Now, text editors are usually the simplest to set up. Examples are Vim, Nano, Notepad++, basically anything that you can write the code in, save it to file, and then run it separately. Links for more information about all of these text editors will be in the description, but essentially it doesn't really matter what text editor you use. You could technically use Microsoft Word if you wanted to. The point is, you just write the code, run it separately. Now, integrated development environments have loads of features. It's essentially combining the text editing step with the running step. Now, when I say it has loads of features, what I mean is that integrated development environments are usually what people use when they're writing large software projects. So it has things like code completion, usually Git integration so you can version control your code, a bunch of other things. For our purposes, we're going to be calling both VS Code and Atom integrated development environments for Julia. There used to be another project called Juno, but I think the Juno developers are combining their work into VS Code soon. The point is that both of these could be considered text editors with additional features instead of true integrated development environments. And trust me, my Twitch chat was really, really keen on pointing out the difference between these. But I generally consider any environment that combines both the editing step and the running step into one as an integrated development environment. And so we'll be showing these off in a bit. Finally, the third programming environment is also the one we've been using the most for this class, and those are notebooks. These are really good for classes because they're essentially markdown text with code inbuilt into it that you can run, which is really useful for a number of different purposes. And the notebooks that most people use for Julia are Pluto.jl, which we've been using again mostly for this class, and also Jupyter. At this point, I think it's worth showing an example for all of these different editors. So first of all, I'm going to be showing a very simple Vim example. What you're seeing here is me writing a full script in Vim with Twitch chat on the side. I'm writing an example that's available in the algorithm archive for generating a Sierpinski triangle. As you can see here, there's a bunch of different plugins to Vim that allow for you to have syntax highlighting and a bunch of other things, but this is generally the flow. You write code in one terminal, you run it in another terminal. Like I said, it's the easiest thing to set up, so it shouldn't be too difficult to pick up as long as you can understand the text editor that you're using. Now, Vim is not necessarily the text editor I would choose for beginners, but it's what I use and I like it a lot. So now I'm going to show you the general workflow for Visual Studio. This is significantly different than what we did with Vim in that you can see way more of the code. What I'm showing you now is the CLIMA project, the climate machine project that I do for work, and I'm showing you how you can kind of use some features in Visual Studio to make it easier to parse large code. You can open up your own terminal and run whatever code you want in your terminal. If you want Julia to work with Visual Studio, it's really important that you get the right plugin specifically for Julia, which I'm showing off here. Now, another point about Visual Studio is that we will be having a short mini lecture on how to use Visual Studio specifically with Julia in the near future. So keep that in mind. We'll be doing this again soon. And finally, notebooks. We've already talked a lot about notebooks for this course, so my assumption is that you already know how to use them. Again, please feel free to check Fonz's lecture if you want more information there. So again, bringing it all back together, different programming environments work better for different people, and you, as a programmer, need to figure out what environment works best for you. If it is genuinely a notebook, then use a notebook. If you like IDEs, use that. If you feel like you're best suited just writing code in a terminal and compiling it, kind of like I am, then do that instead. You just need to make sure you're comfortable in whatever you're coding in. That's the most important thing.